Hi there, Keir here, coming to you live from Burlington, Vermont, on Lake Champlain, as you can see behind me, looking due west of the Adirondack Mountains of upstate New York. I hope you had a great Labor Day weekend, extended weekend. I came up here on a whim to get away, to get creative, and to spend some time by myself. And the topic of this week's video and blog is how to avoid burnout. So I want to talk to you about a few strategies and things that I do to avoid burnout, personally and professionally. And one is doing exactly what I'm doing, which is creating space in my life to vacation, to recreate, to have downtime, to unwind, to read, to get creative, to work on the future, to work on myself, to just relax. And I do this at least once a quarter, but usually a little bit more. And these can often be whimsical trips, like it was on Saturday when I just decided I wanted to hop in the car and drive, 2 hours up here, and I took the ferry. It's a very nostalgic place for me. I used to go to a camp on the lake behind me here in Grand Isle growing up, and I love this place. If you haven't been, I highly encourage you to come. It's a beautiful part of the world and of the Northeast. So creating space to vacation, to unwind, to relax is really important. The next thing I do to avoid burnout is meditate regularly. And I do this usually every morning for at least 5 minutes, sometimes 10. Although I'm working on this and it's hard for me to meditate for much longer because my mind's always moving and always, at pace, not at rest. So meditation though allows me to center myself, to collect my energy, to focus on not focusing, right? To be at a level of mindfulness where I'm not focused on thoughts, I'm focused on just being. And in a busy world, with a lot of us are busy entrepreneurs and professionals, before the day gets started, before it gets crazy, a centeredness exercise, even if it's just for a couple minutes to start, can be really powerful. The next thing that I do is I read regularly. I read a lot. I consume a lot of information, usually 3 to 4 books a month, several podcast episodes a week, documentaries, and things that are educational on TV and movies, not just entertaining, although that's important too. Fiction and entertainment's important, just in moderation, right? I surround myself and I, put into my mind things that will educate, enrich, and a little bit entertain me. And that's important because it allows me to avoid burnout, to avoid always thinking and doing and focusing on my businesses, on my career, on the future. And a lot of us as ambitious entrepreneurs and professionals and business owners do just that. We have trouble turning off, creating balance, and segmenting our day and our life and our schedule. So this can really help. Meditating regularly, spending time to read and put into your mind positive ideas, but also entertaining things like fiction and watching the right things, not just things to pass the time or entertain us, but to educate, enlighten, and inspire us. And then vacationing, again, taking time off, even if it's 2 or 3 days by yourself, with your loved one, with your kids, with your family, with your friends, doing it at least once a quarter, protecting that time so that you can do that, unwind, debrief, not focus on work, focus on you, the things you love to do, and the people that you love to do those things with. So hopefully you get some value from this. Again, just a couple quick strategies on what I do to avoid burnout in a very hectic world and career of mine, running multiple businesses. These things really help me. Hopefully they'll help you. If you're not already doing them, give them a try. See what they produce, see what happens, and drop me a comment or a line below or a DM, direct message, email, like whatever it is. Connect with me, let me know how you're doing. And again, share this with somebody who could benefit from this message too. To your success and happiness, we'll talk to you next week.